Hey, Dirt Detectives. It's time for another lesson. One of the things we learned that we find in soil or dirt are rocks. And so today we're going to talk about all the different sizes of things that we call rocks. Okay, I mean like this, something this big. Are those rocks? Yeah, I bet you think they're definitely rocks. How about things this big? Yeah, they're rocks. Okay. How about something like this? Do you count these as rocks? Or how about this? Something this small rocks. Wow, how about down to this? Is this stuff rock? How small do you get before it's not rocks? Or is it always rocks because of something else? Let's investigate, and we're going to find that out.
Big rocks, small rocks. The earth is covered in rocks. Rocks are even under the oceans. And these are all rocks that were made millions of years ago. Some of these rocks were formed where oceans used to be. Some came from volcanoes, like the rocks we find in the cliffs along the shore of Lake Superior. So, how do rocks get to be different sizes? They break apart over and over again. Scientists group the rocks by what size they are. Let's go from the biggest kind of rock to the smallest kinds of rocks. At first, big pieces break off. These are boulders. We find boulders in many places, at the bottoms of cliffs, in the middle of the woods, even buried under roads. The picture on the right is from an old newspaper. It shows my grandfather standing by a boulder that was uncovered when the city was working on the road. They buried the boulder in an enormous hole. It's still there today. We use boulders for walls. They help hold the soil in place. But eventually, boulders break apart into smaller pieces. These smaller rocks are called cobbles. They're about the size of your head. People sometimes place cobbles along the edge of a garden as a decorative edge, and we often use them to build walls in our different buildings. When cobbles break apart, the smaller pieces are called pebbles. Pebbles are used in lots of places, like gardens or on roads, and they protect the soil underneath. Pebbles break down into sand. If you pick up a handful of sand, you can still see each little individual piece. Most of the time we think of sand being on beaches, but we use it for things like making icy sidewalks safe. Sand particles are pretty small, but we're not done, because sand can break down into particles that are so tiny, they feel like powder. This rock is silt. Think about a time you walked down a dirt road and you kicked at the ground. It got dusty, right? Well, that dust was actually silt, rocks that have been broken down into super tiny pieces. So is silt the smallest kind of rock? Nope. Even silt can be broken down into smaller pieces. The very smallest is clay. Clay particles are so small, you'd need a powerful microscope to see them. We use clay to make things like pottery and beads and bricks. So rocks are big and rocks can be small, and we give them different names depending on their size. But what causes the rocks to break apart? It happens because of water or wind or ice or plants. These are things that can break rocks into smaller and smaller pieces. Scientists call this process weathering. One kind of weathering happens because of water. Rocks that are by water get broken up when the water moves back and forth. The waves carry rocks. Those rocks bump into other rocks over and over again, rubbing off tiny pieces. The rocks get smaller and smoother. Another way water breaks up rocks happens when it's cold. In winter, water gets into cracks in the rocks and it freezes. The ice in the cracks is actually strong enough to push on the rock and make the cracks bigger. Eventually, the crack is big enough that a piece of the rock will fall off. This happens over and over again, making the rock into smaller and smaller pieces. One last way that water can break up rocks is because of glaciers. These are thick slabs of ice that cover the ground. Frozen into the glacier, especially at the bottom, are rocks. The rocks get dragged along as the glacier slowly moves. When the front part of the glacier melts, rocks are left behind, rocks of all sizes, from boulders to silt. Another thing that breaks down rock is wind. Strong winds can carry tiny rock particles. When these particles hit boulders and other rocks, it rubs against them, slowly wearing the rock away. One of the most amazing ways that rocks get broken apart is when lichens grow in them. Those orange and gray splotches you see? Those are lichens. They're alive, but they aren't plants. Lichens make chemicals that slowly eat away at the rock. If the tiny rock particles collect in cracks and a seed lands there, plants may start growing. Mosses and other plants may grow first. As the roots push down into the cracks, the rock is pushed apart. If a tree seed lands in a crack, a tree can grow out of the rock. Usually, it takes a long, long time for rocks to break from big pieces into smaller and smaller pieces. I mean, we're talking thousands of years. But once in a while, something happens, and we get to see some of that weathering happen. Do you see these pictures? This happened a couple of years ago in St. Paul, Minnesota. All of a sudden, part of the cliff gave way, boom, smash. These huge slabs of rock fell onto the road below. They had to actually close down the road. Another time, there was a drone flying along the coast of Lake Superior. Watch what they got to see. So if you watch to the right, you'll see when the cliff gives way and everything falls down into the water. There's a huge splash. They'll repeat it a second time a little bit closer up. Now they're going to do it one more time, even closer. Do you see the big pieces laying at the foot of the cliff? Do you see some of those boulders? They're there because of weathering, because of water that freezes, water that comes in the form of waves. Weathering makes big rocks into smaller rocks. So now it's your turn. With a grown-up, go outside on a rock hunt. Can you spot any boulders, cobbles, pebbles? How about sand or silt? Do you see places where plants or lichens are growing and changing rocks? Can you find places where people are using rocks to protect soil? There's lots you can investigate, dirt detectives. Thanks for joining Dodge for another distance learning lesson. Bye!